Hey folks, in this video, I'm going to show you how to replace a breaker. I want to replace a 20 amp breaker with a 30 amp breaker. Here's the breaker box. Before you do anything with this breaker box, you want to turn off everything. You don't want to just shut down the main switch, which is a 10 kiloamp switch. You want to turn off the individual switches. These are probably going to switch off the light. So I'm going to open the garage door to get some light into the garage before I switch this off. So hang on a second. Here goes. We'll turn everything off. Those off. There's the garage light going off. So now everything is off. Now you turn off the main switch like that. Now we're gonna have to remove this box. Let's do that next. And sometimes the panel can be hot, so that's why I've turned off all the power to make sure that this panel is not hot. You never want to do this without turning off the main breaker switch. That's a recipe for disaster. So let's get all the screws out. Take off the panel. And we'll go from here. Leave that one on because we don't want the thing falling on the floor. That top screw, I'm just going to leave it. The breaker that I want to replace is breaker number 5, which is this breaker right here. Third one from the bottom. Don't do this if you're not comfortable around high voltage, high power electrical equipment. Okay, here's your box. Now, there's copper wires or your ground wires. I want to replace this breaker right here, third from the bottom. And before I touch anything, I'm going to get myself some rubber gloves, and then I'm going to use a voltage checker. Let's check for any live wires. Nothing showing us live. Which is good. Okay, now, let's remove our breaker. There we go. Then you want to rock this thing out. Move this wire out of my way. Here comes. Out. 20 amp breaker out. And we're going to replace that with a 30 amp breaker. That's this breaker right here. 30 amps. Put that one in. There we go, that's it. Make sure it's on. Now, let's secure the wire back. I've just put the wire in. Now, we're going to put the panel back and then turn everything back on. We've got the main front plate back on and I'm just tightening up the screws. Now, before we do anything, first turn on the main power, like that. Now, turn on each individual switch. Lights back on in the garage. Set. So basically that's how you want to do it. You want to make sure you've turned off the main switch, but you don't want to just switch the main switch off with power running in each breaker. You want to switch each individual breaker off, then switch the main switch off. Then you test your unit to make sure there's no hot lines anywhere. When there are no hot lines, use a voltage tester. I use this thing here. Let me just show you now. You've got hot lines there now. I'm going to make sure there are no hot lines. Then you remove the front panel. And then you can safely remove the breaker that you want to switch out. So I switched out this one here, which is a 30 amp breaker for the receptacles. Simply because I'm interested in running some induction heaters and Tesla coils. They tend to draw more current than your normal appliance. And that's why I needed to do that. And here's my breaker. That's always going to be useful. I can still use that if something goes wrong with any of these other ones. Thanks for watching, guys, and please check back. If you don't feel comfortable doing this type of switch out, please call your electrician. Peace out.